Hi students, how are you all? I believe you are all keeping well. Well students, in our today's session, we are going to begin with Unit 6 Reading B, which is titled as A Plea for India. Now, what do you understand by the word plea? Plea is a request. Before we get into the actual part of our poem, let's get know what the poem A Plea for India is all about. So before we get into the actual part of our poem, let's know the ideas and the concepts that are present in the poem. It is a request for Indians to keep their nation strong and not to disturb the nation with internal disputes. In order to symbolize the charm of the nation, we should maintain unity irrespective of caste, region or religion. Instead of creating problems, we should solve the incomplete tasks. Violence leads to sorrow, so let us not lose our lives in hatred. Instead, love one another to make our country sacred. There are still many aspects to be concentrated upon. So, let us give a serious, humble thought for the development of the nation. There are people who cheat one another, perform rot, and make their life hopeless. The communal riots leads us to shame and disgrace, which can be controlled with the willful nature towards a triumphant India. Let us make the saying, "Unity is strength," a truthful proverb and build up a strong nation. This is possible only through commitment, determination and courage to face challenges. Well students, now let's get into the actual part of our poem. We Indians are proud to be a strong nation. Our roots, we declare, cannot be shaken. Then, why these fights which leave us in poor light? Irrespective of our region, forget the castes, which makes us lose our charm. Let's discuss and learn some of the words that are present in the stanza. The meaning of roots is a basic source or origin of something. Declare is to announce. Plight. The meaning of plight is, you know, trouble or, you know, a difficult or sad situation. Irrespective, regardless of, or, you know, without taking account of. Charm, the power of attracting others. The meaning of charm is the power of attracting others. So we Indians are very proud to be a strong nation. So we take pride in saying that we are Indians and we are proud to be a strong nation. You understand strong nation? Now, our roots, our basic source or, you know, origin of our roots cannot be shaken. We declare, we announce that they cannot be shaken. Then, why these fights? Why all the fights and violence that take place when we say we are strong nation? Which leave us in poor plight. The meaning of plight is, you know, a difficult or a sad situation. When there are fights create, you know, violence. As a result, a kind of the atmosphere which is sad is created. So, the poet says, when we say we are strong nations and our roots cannot be shaken, then why all these fights that are happening in the country which leave us in poor plight? When there are fights, they leave us in sad situation. Irrespective of our region, forget the castes which make us lose our charm. India is a country of diverse cultures, languages, caste system and, you know, different castes that are existing in the country. So the poet says, irrespective of our region, forget the castes which make us lose our charm. The power of being attractive. We lose our charm when we concentrate on our region or you know when we concentrate on our you know our caste, our own. Please understand, we Indians take pride in saying that we are a strong nation in spite of diverse cultures, languages, you know, religions that are existing in India. In spite of all these differences, but still we accept and will live together as a strong nation. So the poet says, then why all these fights? When there is a fight, they leave us in sad situation, poor plight. Poor plight is, you know, a difficult or sad situation. As a result, we lose our charm, the power of being attractive. Let's ignore the selfish call of each region and listen for once to the call of the nation. Why do we spend our time bickering when so many tasks need finishing? Let's discuss some of the words that are present. The meaning of ignore is to neglect or pay no attention to. Bickering is arguing about things that are not important, indulging in, you know, unimportant things like backbiting. Task, a work to be completed. A work to be completed. Now the poet says, let us neglect the selfish call of the region, being selfish to one's own region, instead to answer the call of the nation for the betterment of the world and not the selfish call of one's own region. Now, why do we spend our life in bickering in unimportant things when we have so much of things to be completed, so much of work to be completed? Do you understand? So the poet says, let us ignore, let us neglect the selfish call of the region. Instead, let us answer the call of the nation as a whole. And let us not spend our time, our life in unimportant things, in bickering, backbiting, or, you know, arguing about things that are unimportant. Instead, you know, engage or indulge oneself in creating a peaceful environment. So the poet says, when we have so much of work to be completed, why do we spend our time in unimportant things? Don't we have better things to do than indulge in creating problems anew? Is all this violence needed with the people being cheated? Now, what is meant by indulge? Take pleasure in, or you know, make fuss of. Engaging oneself in activity, indulge. Violence, you understand, fighting or, you know, cruelty. So the poet says, don't we have better things to do than indulging or, you know, engaging oneself in creating new problems? Why are we creating new problems? Don't we have any work or, you know, better work to do than indulging oneself in creating problems? Is all this violence needed? Do we need all this violence? With the people being cheated. Now what happens? Innocent people are becoming the victims of all this violence. So the poet says, there are still many aspects to be concentrated upon. So let us give a serious, humble thought for the development of the nation. And there are people who cheat one another and perform rot and make their life hopeless. It's simple. Who will return this only son whom she loves a ton? Who will bring back his brother whose ashes he is still to gather? What is meant by return? Return is to give back. Return, give back, gather. Gather is to collect. Okay, now ashes, it's a powdery residue left after burning of substance. Now, when the dead body is burnt, okay, we find only later ashes, right? It's a, you know, substance that is, you know, that is present after burning of something, okay? Who will return this only son? Now, what do you understand as a result of violence, riots? What happens? People engage in, conflicts, fights. As a result, people lose their life. There is a lot of bloodshed. So, some people may even die. So, who will return, bring back this only son? Maybe the son is the only one to his, mother, whom she loves a ton. Now, what is meant by she loves a ton, loves so much? She loves her son so much. And the poet says, as he dies in the violence, who will bring the son back? Do you understand? Who will bring back his brother, whose ashes he is still to gather? As I said, as a result of violence and wars, there is a lot of bloodshed and people lose even their life. So who will bring back this brother? That boy could be a brother of, a sister or, his brother or, son to his mother. Who will bring back his life? Whose ashes he is still to gather? Do you understand? Where has all the love gone, which resided in the heart of all? There is no reason to be proud and be on high cloud. What do you understand by the word resided, belonged to a person or a body? Now, on a high cloud, having strong feeling of happiness or satisfaction. Now, the poet says, where has all the love gone which was inside the heart of all of us? The love that we had, where is it? Where does it go? There is no reason to be proud and be on high cloud. So, there is no reason to say, proudly that we are Indians and be satisfied. Now, why does the poet use the expression proud to be a strong nation at the beginning of the poem and, there is no reason to be proud and be on high cloud? It's because, we say strongly that our, nation is very strong with all of us. But when we indulge ourselves in violence, riots, creating a kind of disturbance for the peaceful environment in the country, then there is no reason to say proudly that we are Indians. It's a responsibility of each Indian to contribute from his or her part, or not to create new problems. Instead, to complete the tasks that are entrusted to them, engaging oneself in creating a peaceful environment. We have to go a long way. We have to think seriously, else we end up miserably. Now, what is meant by miserably? Sadly, or in a way, in a mean way. End up, it's to finish, come to an end. A long way, very much far. Far or, a great amount. So the poet says we have to go a long way. We have to go a long way and we have to think seriously about the existing situation of our country. Otherwise, we will end our lives in misery, in a sad situation. So it's a time, it's a high time we thought about our country. Then, let our minds throw out the rot and devote our time to pious thoughts. Let us control the riots which leave us with no choice, but to hang our heads in shame and say we have miserably failed. What do you understand by the word rot? It's a bad things, bad things. Riots, violent disturbance. Pious, virtuous or, moral. Devote, it's to dedicate. Devote is to dedicate. So the poet says, let our minds throw out the rot. Let us remove bad thoughts from our minds. And let us dedicate our time to pious thoughts, virtuous, moral thoughts. Simple. The poet says, let our minds throw out all the bad thoughts. Let us not think all bad thoughts in our minds. Instead, let us dedicate our time to moral thoughts, thinking of moral things. So let's control the riots, let's control the violence, let us try to stop this violence which leaves us with no choice. There is no choice, right? When there is a violence, it creates a lot of disturbance. So the poet says, let us control, let us stop this riots, this violence. But to hang our heads in shame and say we have miserably failed. Now, please understand, why does a poet use the expression proud to be a strong nation at the beginning of the poem and now hang heads in shame? They are two extremes, right? Beginning we say we are proud to be a strong nation, and towards the end the poet says to hang our heads in shame. India is a united country with its varied castes, religions, creeds, communities. We follow unity in diversity that makes our nation a strong nation. In spite of its unity, there are walls of discrimination that lead us to disputes and cause violence. The local and internal disputes that shake the walls of unity hang our heads in shame. So the two expressions are used at the same time. Do you understand? It's simple, please understand. The poet says, let us not think about, bad things in our minds. Let us throw out the rods from our minds. Instead, let us dedicate our time, to pious thoughts, moral thoughts. And let us control the violence that is existing. Otherwise, we will fail miserably. Okay, we'll fail miserably. We have the power to win, so why not end this din? Let us unite and fight against those who incite. The meaning of din is a disturbance. The meaning of din is disturbance. Incite is, encourage somebody to be violent by making angry. So the poet says we have the power to win. So why not end this din? Why can't we end this, riots, violence, disturbances that are existing in the country? So let us unite and fight against the people who are trying to create violence or creating new problems. That's what we see in the next two lines. Let us unite and fight against those who incite, those who are trying to create violence by provoking others. Do you understand? Let us not be misled by those who want to see us dead. We are a strong, united nation. All we need is a bit of dedication. Now, what is meant by misled? Cause to have a wrong idea or impression. Dedication is commitment and perseverance. The poet says, let us not be misled. Let us not give chance for others to go in wrong path or to take wrong direction. And they want us, to be dead, right? So the poet says, let us not be misled, and they want us because they are leading us into wrong direction because they want to see us dead. We are a strong united nation, and we need is a bit of dedication. Dedication is commitment. We say strongly, we say, proudly that we are Indians and we are a strong nation, we are a united nation. But what we need is a bit of dedication, little bit of commitment. Okay, so that no one else can shake our roots. Well, students, I believe you have understood today's session. Have you? See you in the next session.